Are you holding others in your present life hostage for what some might have done to you in the past? If so, please listen closely as we discuss what's in your interpersonal relationship skill toolbox. So, what's in your relationship skill toolbox? My name is Nari Dean Staravera, and welcome to Mindful Monday. So today, we are talking about interpersonal relationships. And by interpersonal relationship, I mean, I'm going to be referring to your parent-child relationship, the romantic relationship, whether it's marriage, dating relationship, or your engaged, and also significant friend relationships. So how did you learn how to be in relationship? Where did you get the idea of, how did you form your worldview or your idea of what it meant or what it looked like to be in a relationship? Well, for, you know, many of us, I think all of us, our worldviews about relationships are really formed by our primary caregivers, primary people in our lives. And by primary, I mean that those people who were the primary people who took care of our need, basic needs, physically, emotionally. And for most of us, it was a dad and a mom. And for others, it might have been a set of grandparents or single mom, single dad, or just et cetera. You fill in the blanks in terms of what your primary relationship looked like. And a lot of times when we find ourselves in maybe in distress and interpersonal relationship, you can definitely trace certain things back to those primary relationships. So what does that look like, right? So in our primary relationships, we learn how to get our needs met. For those who grew up in a secure relationship and primary relationships, they knew that their needs would be met, and they felt very confident and comfortable within those relationships. But for others, they may have experienced neglect, a chaotic household abuse, and all sorts of things that might have led them to experience insecurity in their relationships. So their worldview of relationships were formed by these experiences. And so therefore, when they enter any interpersonal relationship, those patterns can definitely manifest themselves in those relationships. So some examples of what that would look like, right? So if you, for example, grew up in a family dynamic that where your needs were neglected, where you were uncertain when things would happen, you may find yourself in relationships where you're feeling hypervigilant and always looking for cues that sends the message that your needs are not important. And you can find yourself being very reactive and accusing others of not meeting your needs because of your own insecurities due to how you grew up. And for others who might have grown up and families where there might have been some sort of addictive traits or personality disorder characteristics, you might have experienced where a lack of emotional boundary. And so you might find yourself in relationships where you feel like you have to be responsible for others' emotions. You take all the responsibility to make others happy. So how do you identify these patterns in your relationship? So one of the things that I would love for you to do in this coming week, I'm going to give you an exercise, because I do think that we all carry baggages with us. We all do. We all have some sort of broken tools in our interpersonal relationship skill toolbox. So I think in order for us to really know ourselves and how we interact, even if you feel like, you know what, I came from a pretty secure family dynamic and I feel pretty good about how I relate to others, how I relate in my relationship with friends, family, and so on and so forth. I just think that it's a great tool to understand and know yourself better. So the exercise I am going to ask you to do is to name two primary people in your life, whether it's mom or dad or et cetera. You can figure that out for yourself. And write down these five categories in terms of how they have helped you to grow in a healthy way and ways maybe that you might have been harmed. So the first one is consistency. How consistent were they? And the second one is attention. Were they available? Were they attentive to your needs? The third one is responsiveness. Were they able to acknowledge your emotions, your feelings when you're upset? Were they responsive to your needs? The fourth one is empathy. Were they able to validate your emotions and be able to be in there with you and you were feeling understood? And the last one is solution oriented. Were they able to help you to resolve things together, help you to find a sense of, have the ability to really, truly have your issues, but able to give you the tools to resolve them? So if you notice, the acronym that it spells is CARES. So that's the exercise that I would encourage you to do throughout this week. And please share what you're learning. If you are learning anything, even in the comments, you know, throughout the week, please share if there's something that comes up for you, maybe you didn't recognize, and how you engage with others, depending on what need from your child, maybe from your childhood, maybe that wasn't met. Now you might find yourself putting those expectations in the relationships that you're now in. So this is part one of relationship, interpersonal relationship skill toolbox. So stay tuned next week. We will be discussing interpersonal relationship skills in romantic relationships and in significant friendship relationships. So I hope this was helpful. And thank you, and I will see you guys next Monday. Take care. Bye.